you traders, it's Petko Aleksandrov speaking from EA Forex Academy, and today I will talk about the update that we have in the report when we are backtesting trading strategies with EA Studio or when we are generating strategies. So if I go to collection, I have some collection here for Euro dollar on M15 chart, and I will click on any of the strategies. So far, when we were backtesting trading strategies in the backtest output, we were having exact statistics and we were not able to change it. But now if I go to tools and below, you will see backtest output metrics. So here you can select which metrics you want to see in your strategy. You can see there are 5, so you can change it to any other metrics that you want to have while backtesting trading strategies. For example, the first one, I will leave it to net profit, but then instead of profit per day, I can select maximum drawdown in percentage. Then instead of maximum drawdown, I can have the R squared. This is a new feature in EA Studio, which I will explain in some of the next videos about the EA Studio updates. It is very nice, and by using it, we can have very, very nice equity line with the strategies. And for example, I can change return to drawdown. I can change it with maximum stagnation in percentage. Okay, and instead of count of trades, even I really like to see the count of trades, I will select win-loss ratio, all right? And if I go now to the strategy, you will see that I have the net profit, the maximum drawdown, R squared, maximum stagnation, and win-loss ratio. So depending on which ones you want to see, you can change them from here, from the backtest output metrics. Now, if I go to the strategy one more time and I go to report, you will see very, very interesting charts here, which help us to have a better idea when we are backtesting trading strategies, when we're generating strategies, or when we are going to optimize strategies. So here we have more information and more visual outlook of the strategy, and I will explain each one along the video. So on the left side, we have the backtest output. Here we have some updates as well. We have backtest quality, which before was called to be maximum ambiguous bars. And for the new traders with EA Studio, what that means, the ambiguous bars or the backtest quality, is when we have a trading strategy that uses stop loss and take profit, and the stop loss and the take profit is within the range of one bar. So let's say on the backtest of the trading strategy, we have the trade open somewhere here, and then we have the stop loss and the take profit within the range of this bar. So the program cannot decide which one was first. Did the price reach first the take profit? Was it the stop loss? And it's normal because what we have from the historical data is the open, the high, the low, and the close. This is all the information we receive when we export historical data from MetaTrader. And here the MetaTrader backtest gives you a result which is better for you. So it will show you that the take profit was hit, but this is not the reality. We don't know if first was the stop loss or first was take profit. While EA Studio uses account protective algorithm, meaning that when there are such bars, it will take it as a negative. If there are such situations or such bars while backtesting the trading strategy, it will show you the more negative result. So this way it will show the more secure result for the user, okay, for the trader. It will avoid showing overestimated results. So one more time here about the backtest quality, which before was known as ambiguous bars. This is when we have huge bar and our trading strategy has a stop loss and take profit within the range of this bar, and EA Studio, just like MetaTrader, doesn't know which one was hit first, the take profit or the stop loss. And EA Studio will show always the stop loss, so it will show you the more secure result Okay, going down to the backtest output, we have bars in trade. This is update as well, which is very interesting. We can see how active is our strategy. So here we have 56%, meaning that the strategy is trading nearly half of the time. We have the R squared, which, as I said, I will dedicate a whole video in the next days, and I will explain what exactly that means and how you can use it while optimizing the strategies or while you're generating new strategies. All right, so now on the right side, we see the balance chart, and then what we see is count of entries by weekdays. Okay, so this is count of entries. So please pay attention to the names above the charts. It is said there exactly what it is. So this one shows the count of entries. Okay, this is not the profit, but this is count of entries by weekdays. As you see with this historical data, we have some trading on Sunday, so there are some trades over there, and then during Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, you can see it is most active. So here you can see if your strategy is balanced and if it opens trades every day during the week. All right, now the next one is profit and loss in currency by weekdays. So here we have the actual result. The green one shows the profit, the red one shows the loss. And the first thing I see here is that this strategy on Tuesday makes more losses than profits. Okay, so here is in currency, so we can say this is profit and loss. Okay, now going down, we have profit and loss in currency by entry hour, and on the right side we have profit and loss in currency by exit hour. So here we see during which hours this strategy makes more profit, when it makes more losses, and here obviously the strategy makes more profit during the first half of the day, and in the afternoon the trades that were opened in the afternoon, they are making more losses. So here one more time, please carefully read what it says: profit and loss in currency by entry hour. This means that we see the entries of the positions during which hours the entries are leading to a profitable trade and during which hours the entries are leading to losing trades. And here we have the exit hour. So here we can see between midnight and 6, we really don't have exit, very small exits here. Then we have good exits at 8, 9, and then we have great exit at 2 p.m. and then we have smaller results by exit hour. All right, and let's see here what will happen if I go to tools and I set Monday till Thursday. So let's change just the hours and see how the graph will change. So let's make it from 10 trading till 1400 hours. Okay, and I will do the very same thing for Friday. I will do it from 10 to 1400 hours. And I will go to strategy. You see it changed, and I go to report, and you will see exactly here I have trading only between 10 and 2 p.m. but I have exits all the time. Okay, because this is only the entry, and the exit could be at any time. And there is some trading over here at 10 and 11 p.m. I think this is just because of the trading on Sunday, because this broker has some trading on Sunday and I didn't eliminate it. If I eliminate it, I will go back to the strategy and I will go to report, and you see there is no such trading over here. All right, so I really hope that by changing these hours, I made it clear. This graph on the left shows the profit and the loss by entry hour, and on the right side, we have the profit and the loss by exit hour. Okay, let me put it back to the normal that I'm keeping. It's from midnight till midnight. Okay, I'm not missing any trading time. And keep in mind that this settings in tools are general, and if you change them and then you load some old collection or strategy or expert advisor, it will affect the report of this trading strategy. All right, and I will go back one more time to the report and I will show you what I have below. We have two more things. One is count of entries, profits and losses by entry hour. Now the blue bars show the count of trades, the green bars are showing the profitable trades, and the red ones are showing the count of the losing trades. So obviously the blue bar equals the green bar plus the red bar. So here we have the count of the entries, the profits and the losses by trading hours. Alright, and below we have the monthly performance in currency, something very interesting to me. You can see the results while backtesting the trading strategies for the whole trading period that we have with the whole historical data. In this case, it starts at October 2014, and the months where we have huge losses are colored in red, and those where we have smaller losses are in a lighter color, and same with the profitable months where we have profits is in light green, but where we have more profits is in darker green. And this way we can see, for example, that this strategy makes profits in July. Okay, it makes profits as well in February. With the other months, it is having some months on profits, some on losses. You can see in June, it has 2 months on profit and 2 months in loss. So by having this statistics over here, you can have much better idea about the trading strategy, about the profits and the losses. And if you decide, you can actually pause the strategy when it is not making profit, for example, in the afternoon with this trading strategy, or you can have a look at the months as well. You can make a lot of conclusions over here, and it is up to you how you will use these statistics to improve your trading. All right, thank you very much for watching. This was about the statistical information that we have now as an update in EA Studio, which is very useful to analyze our work while we are backtesting trading strategies, or when we are generating strategies and we have them into the collection, we can quickly go to the report and have a better idea about the strategy, not only looking the balance chart, but looking at all of these statistics. Thank you for watching, and I wish you safe trading. Cheers.